Tuesday is a special election for the 1st District congressional seat in South Carolina, which is one of two seats in Congress that's currently vacant. It had been held by a Republican, Tim Scott, until the start of the year. So after a primary election in March and then a runoff in April, we're down to two candidates. The Republican is Mark Sanford. He actually held this seat for three terms until 2001 and then went on to win two terms as South Carolina governor. The latter half of his second term as governor was thrown off course after he admitted that he had cheated on his wife with a woman from Argentina. That looked like it was going to be the end of his career, but when Senator Jim DeMint resigned last December, it started a string of dominoes that led Sanford to seek a bid for Congress. It was something he's calling a little bit of a redemption effort now. In Elizabeth Colbert Busch, they found in many ways the perfect candidate. She has a long career in business, working on local development, international trade, and has ties to Clemson University, where she serves in an executive position. Of course, she's most famous, though, as the sister of Comedy Central star Stephen Colbert.
As a broadcast journalist, I am obligated to maintain pure objectivity. It doesn't matter that my sister is intelligent, hardworking, compassionate, and dedicated to the people of South Carolina. I will not be mentioning any of that on my show.
He's helped his sister raising money and holding events with her and also giving her a lot of free airtime on his show. But Colbert Busch, she's been trying to make sure voters see her as a person of substance in her own right. The race now is a statistical tie. Sanford actually leads by 1 point, but it's within the margin of error. We say this all the time in politics, but it's absolutely true in this case. It's going to come down to turnout, whether it's unions and Democratic interest groups on the left, or some of the conservative outside forces. We saw Mark Sanford endorsed by the National Tea Party movement over the weekend. They're really going to make the difference here in making sure that their base supporters get out. At this point, it really looks like it is going to be a toss-up in the final hours.